Hi, I'm Pat Keon, a senior research analyst with Thomson Reuters Lipper. I'm here to speak to you about the fund flows activity for the week ended Wednesday, February 21st. We'll start this week's report by taking a quick look at the market activity for the week. Volatility and interest rate fears hit the market again last week after six consecutive positive trading sessions for both the Dow Jones Industrial Average and the S&P 500 Index. News from the Fed spooked the markets. The release of the FOMC meeting minutes on Wednesday the 21st sent the Dow Jones Industrial Average into a tailspin as the minutes indicated that the Fed is viewing the economy as stronger than it was at the end of the year, and at the current rate they do feel that multiple interest rate hikes will be necessary in 2018. This sent the Dow Jones down over 500 points as it was trading above up 300 points on the day, and it closed down almost 170 points on the day after the release of the minutes. Let's turn our attention back now to the fund flows activity. We'll start by taking a look at our macro groups. Equity mutual funds had net inflows of $3.6 billion on the week. Taxable bond funds saw positive flows of $935 million. Muni bond funds took in $366 million, and money market funds had the largest net inflows for the week at $12.3 billion. We'll take a closer look at each of the macro groups now, starting with our equity fund groups. As previously mentioned, equity mutual funds took in $3.6 billion. What was unusual this week, for a change, we saw domestic equity funds with positive net inflows. They took in about $750 million in net new money for the week, paced by S&P 500 index funds, which had net inflows of just over $430 million. On the other side, for non-domestic equity, business as usual there, net inflows for them about $2.8 billion. Leading the pack this week for non-domestic equity funds was the International Multicap Growth Peer Group, which had net inflows of roughly $870 million on the week. We'll look at equity ETFs now. This group saw net outflows last week, its third straight net outflows, as $2.5 billion left their coffers. Once again, the SPDR S&P 500 product led the way for net outflows. It had about $4.2 billion leave. Contributing to the total net outflows was also the iShares Russell 2000 ETF, with about $1.5 billion leaving their coffers. And on the flip side, the iShares Core MSCI Emerging Markets product took in about $1 billion for the fund flows week. Let's move on now. We'll look at another asset group, taxable bond funds. We'll start with our mutual funds. This group had net inflows last week, about $935 million in total. We're seeing the same key players that we've seen over the last few weeks, money flowing into the core bond peer groups. Core bond funds themselves took in about $838 million last week, and core plus bond funds had net inflows of $230 million, while on the net outflow side, it was still people staying away from the riskier assets as high yield funds saw about $925 million in net outflows last week. Take a look at taxable bond ETFs now. Net inflows for this group last week, they took in about $1.3 billion in net new money. The main contributors among the individual ETFs was the SPDR Bloomberg Barclays high yield product, had net inflows of $453 million. The iShares short-term treasury product took in about $243 million. And on the net outflow side of the equation, we see the iShares iBox investment-grade corporate product with net outflows of roughly $790 million. We'll move on to our next asset group now, muni bond funds. Net inflows for this group last week, about $366 million in net new money for them. The major player here last week were funds in the intermediate muni debt bond fund peer group, had net inflows of about $475 million. That was the most significant net inflow. We saw little ones here and there, but on the net outflow side, we saw a couple of interesting things. Some of the shorter maturities, the short intermediate muni debt funds and the short muni debt funds peer groups had net outflows of just about $50 million each last week. Our last group to take a look at is money market funds. Large net inflows here this week, about $12.3 billion. It was our second straight week of net inflows. The largest net inflows amongst the peer group belongs to the institutional U.S. government and institutional U.S. Treasury money market funds, which had net inflows of about $6.8 and $5.1 billion respectively. While on the net outflow side, we saw the U.S. government money market fund group had about $3.4 billion leave their coffers. Well, that wraps up this week's report. If you'd like to take a closer look at the data for yourself, please go to our website at www.lipperusfundflows.com, and please join us here again next week where another one of our analysts will be speaking about that week's fund flows activity.